guys, welcome back to Let's Talk World. And you know, I've been saying this, we are here at Chancla's Cantina because I love it when I say it, because they're amazing. Eddie and Megan actually take care of me all time here. I've been with them for 1.5 years, and on our 6 months we actually have this woman right here.
Hi.
With Bree, the Mimi and Bree.
Yep.
Welcome.
Yep.
Back.
Welcome everybody, we miss you. Mimi's not with me at the moment, but it's all right.
So do you speak to Mimi yet?
I still do.
What she said?
She does want to continue the Mimi and Bree idea. We're trying to figure out, because our schedules don't match now.
Oh yeah?
Yeah, so I'm thinking if like maybe
I'll come with you guys.
Yeah, like we do like a random date, right? I go like, hey Mimi, meet me here. And then I'll just, and then do like a random date.
Yeah. Oh no, we're gonna have you guys here together.
Yeah.
Is she off on Wednesday?
No, off on Tuesday. Yeah, so I'm thinking maybe Tuesdays. Or maybe like a Monday.
But you are not?
That's it.
But anyways guys, yes. Few months ago, I have a Bree here on my show. Mm-hmm. And this woman, if you, okay, let's put it this way. When I met this woman, I am heads over heels. Heels over, what? Head over heels.
Head over heels.
Yeah, I got it the first time. Back.
Yes.
Head over heels with this woman. She's just the most adorable person that you could imagine. She's freaking nice, but she's bitchy.
I can be.
Literally, when I look at myself, I am the innocent one, but I already have that bitchy face. Does that make sense? But
yeah.
She is the one like she is like adorable, sweet girl, and then, whoop, no, honey, you fucking cross the line. This is the type of girl. When me is like, oh, I'm not crossing. You see, this is the separate looks that we have.
Like the opposite, huh?
Yes, exactly.
Like, I like to keep people on their toes. Like I like to have everybody think like I'm this innocent girl.
Yes.
Like, oh, she probably doesn't know much. She's probably from like, you know, some Farmville or something.
Yeah, yeah.
And then I like to come back and just be like, no.
Oh, no, no, honey. Don't fucking, I'm the kind of girl that I'm so bitchy, but once you know me well, like, not like in 6 months, in a year or 2 years, you're gonna know me well to actually for me to uncover who am I. See what I'm saying?
Yeah. I'd like to be a little bit of a mystery.
Yeah.
Keep everybody on their feet.
Yes. That's this, oh my God. I shouldn't be saying this, but my daughter actually, I kinda like, I'm not gonna say anything more, but I said, I kinda like a guy, and then my daughter stepped in and said, Mom, I know you well, so I'll help you. And I'm like, I don't need a help, honey. And she was like, no, okay, let me get his birthday, where he was born, and give me his personal profile. I'm like, no. He's like, no, you gotta have to. Like, I already did my background check. Why you have to do your background check? I said, well, to make sure that I like this guy.
Oh, she wants to see if she's compatible with him and everything and help you out. That's awesome.
Yeah, it's helping out.
Yeah.
It's so freaking hilarious this morning. I was like, honey, I already did mine. Don't worry about it. But yeah, finally, I like somebody.
Well, congratulations.
No, it's not.
I'm actually shocked, honestly. Really?
No, yeah, but anyways, yeah. I hope you're not watching right now because fuck it.
No, I'm really happy though, because like I remember you're like the woman where all the guys go, yeah? And then you're just like, no. I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah,
I don't know my thing.
Yeah, who are you?
So someone to be able to catch you. That's you.
But it's not about me, it's about this girl. So how is it with you now? It's been how many months?
Has it been six? No. No. It's been four?
Yeah, four.
Four months, I think. Yeah. Yeah, I had to go on vacation. A 4 month vacation.
4 month vacation.
I'm back.
4 months. Like, I keep on texting there almost like once a week maybe?
Yes.
How are you though?
I know. I've been so super busy, but now things are better. I have more free time. I'm excited to actually get out and do stuff again. So yeah, I'm back.
Please cook, you should be here. But anyway, for them.
Yeah.
And I hope for good.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm really like very flattered when you tell me that, and I am so I believe that, you know, like what I said to you before, that if you see some opportunity, go ahead, because I'm happy for you. I never actually give any bad vibes to anybody who's leaving me, because I know that they're doing it because I'm gonna do the same.
Yeah.
Does that make sense?
Yeah,
if I, you know, if I gotta have to move on, I'll do that. And that's what good about me is, like, I love everybody.
Same here.
I love you.
You love me too.
And she was like, just join me on my job. I'm like, I wish I could.
It's alright, it's always there available for me, you know, whenever. But
so yeah, so how's, you know, how's everything else for the last? You don't have to spill the personal one, but
yeah, no, everything else has been fairly well. Because COVID and everything's opening up again. I'm looking at planning trips to go to places. You know, I do want to go to Alaska.
You know what? Oh my God! Yeah. Bring me with you.
Yeah, I'm trying to take
me with
a
you.
Trip there.
Yeah, because that's one of my
like bucket lists.
Yeah, bucket
list. Yeah. So I'm like, okay, you know, I have work life, you know, my friend life, and then I want me and my bucket list, and so I'm writing it out, and I want to kind of start doing all of it. So Alaska's one of them. Unfortunately, Australia is another one, but I'm going to have to wait for a few years.
Yeah, I know, right? I want Australia, so I want to go on a safari
race. Or like on the coast?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So what Mimi and Bree plans?
We're planning, I have a few plans. I've been wanting to talk to her. Because I know she's like, yeah, I want to start. She's messaged me a few times going, hey, when are we going to start doing a show again? And I'm like, soon. And now I'm like, hey, when are we? And then she's like, hold on.
You gotta have to push her.
Yeah.
You know our friend Mimi.
She's such a sweetheart.
Oh, she's a very... I know you have seen her in the past, but she's just amazing. I never talked to her.
She adds the spice.
Yes.
Know? Yeah. So we mold where we work well, but we're just different in some ways, and it just works. You know.
I know. I love it. I love our group actually. Mimi, Mimi and Bree with Maria. It's just like it's kind of like a
family friend.
Yeah, it's just like a
connection.
Something like you would right away.
So yes, so I've been kind of thinking about in Vegas there's themed bars.
Yes.
A lot of people don't know that about Vegas, that we have arcade bars here. I mean, we have bars for other types of themes. And so I was thinking if I could talk to some of the people, go to some of those theme bars and just randomly invite her. And then do
I think I like that. And I just show up with camera.
Yeah, and just be like, okay, Mimi, make sure you dress nice. And yeah. She'd be like, wait, why?
Because I want to dress nice tonight.
Yeah,
Mimi.
I want pictures with you.
Thank you, darling.
I think she would like it. You know?
Yeah, I think so too.
Yeah.
Yeah, I just, you know, Bree is just totally one of my favorite people in the planet Earth, actually. It's not just in Las Vegas, in planet Earth. So you know what that says. When she has to go for good reasons, I'm heartbroken at the same time. If I am here for you.
Yes.
Hey, Megan.
Oh, snap. So nobody want to hear what I gotta say.
I know, right?
We all do.
By the way, this is Megan, by the way. Bree is actually my assistant for a long time, but she has to go temporarily. Now she's back.
Yay! Yeah, back.
How was that smurf?
It was delicious.
She had a sassy smurf.
It was very good. It tasted I can't explain it. It was like lemony blueberry.
Lemonade blueberry?
Yes.
What is it?
So the Sassy Smurf is my only Smurf with whiskey in it.
Ooh.
All my other Smurfs have tequila, but that's a whiskey Smurf.
I love my Patron.
And it's purple.
Yes,
it is. That's my Patron tequila all the time.
Yes.
Oh, can I say something? This is gonna be bad.
I own a bar. Everything's bad in my
you
world.
So, you see, when she makes
and
my...
in Vegas.
You know what happens at Chancla's stays at Chancla's. So,
you know that... when you make my margarita, I fucking give 100 stars. When your bartender make my margarita, I gave them 80 stars.
Okay, well, I'll have a conversation.
Yeah,
you but gotta, you know what? It doesn't matter. Like, no matter what, they never make it like me.
I think what she's trying to say is that it's your love she wants.
I mean, you know. Yeah. I have to tell you the most frustrating part as an owner, because consistency is like very important behind the bar, right?
Yes.
So the most frustrating part for me is I literally have these, I don't make the cocktails any different than the cocktail recipe
says to make it.
But then other people go behind the bar and it never tastes
they
the
put
same.
A little more this
or less.
Or, that.
Or less. Yeah. Or whatever it is. And I'm like, nothing is more frustrating to me as an owner than when I have to get up if I'm on the other side of the bar and I have to get up and go make somebody's drink because they're not making it right. And I'm like,
I was like, when you were at
my face
when you went to New Mexico,
yeah.
I was like, I'm not gonna say it, but because anywho, I still love no matter what, as long as they're making it, so what, and drinking it.
Well, this is true, but I'm very, as a bar owner / bartender, I'm so picky when I get my drinks because I know how my drinks come out, and then I go somewhere else and I'm like, what are you doing?
Exactly, right?
Like, I'm
going back to Chancla's Cantina. I don't like this drink when I go someplace. I'm like, no, I'm good now. I literally
always end up at my own bar.
I can see that. Like the drink you gave me. So I was just trying to think of like what the drink, like what can I compare it to? I would have to say like a white blueberry gummy bear.
Oh my
God.
So it's like a gummy bear. It tastes like a gummy bear.
She was like, she sipped it like one time. And it's gone. I was like,
I ran over there.
I was like, but anyways, we are here at Chancla's Cantina by Thunderbird at 1215 South Las Vegas Boulevard. And like what I keep on telling them, every Wednesday when I'm here, because I'm here every Wednesday, the hot wings is 50% off.
Half price wings.
Yes.
And they're delicious.
Yes. Oh, the best.
Oh, same here.
Yeah. So anyway, thank you for
having
me.
Thank you. Come see us.
Yes. What is that?
Your bride is here.
Happy bride.
I didn't do it.
Oh my goodness, that guacamole is good. What is
so good?
Do you know that their drinks here, they is freshly squeezed. They squeeze their, the lemon and everything in it. So it's not, it's not other like other places that they have to actually put a synthetic. Here is all real.
Wow, that's why there's so much flavor. Have you had their guacamole yet?
No, let me try.
You have to try it.
I never tried their guacamole.
I have never had guacamole like that before.
I want to try their salsa too. They bring salsa too.
Oh my gosh, I bet you it is amazing.
Love it.
Yeah, I'm super picky about my food too.
Thanks for the morning.
Come on.
But anyways, guys, this is the Let's Talk World here at socialmediashows.com.
Let's talk Annie. And drink.
Come on down. Eat some food with us.
Yeah. Uh-huh. The guacamole is bomb.
And by the way, today we don't have two hot chicks because something actually emergency happened. So not really like serious emergency. So we're not going to have two hot chicks today, but we have Let's Talk World, right?
Yeah.
I want to have you as a two hot chicks every Wednesday. We'll talk about that.
Possibly. Two hot chicks and a third.
But anyways, guys, I just want to show them our event The event is this Saturday, 6 to 9 p.m. here at Junkos Cantina by Thunderbird. And we're gonna have so much fun. Please go ahead and register now. Register at onenightstandvegasstyle.com. You're gonna pay $10, but you have a one free drink with a $10. So it's kind of like wash off. So please go ahead and register now. The earlier the better, because we are literally looking for bachelor and bachelorette that we are blindfolding for that night. So please go and register, fill up the form and send it to us so that we can actually set you up right away for the blindfold dating. Because blindfold dating is the most fun one, don't you think?
I've done speed dating, but I've never done blindfold dating.
Oh, it's gonna be fun.
Can I do that even if I'm with someone?
Yes, yes, yeah. Hold on, what did I do? But yeah, you should. Oh my God, you're gonna be the best, like, oh shit.
That would be so much fun.
You know, I was thinking.
And I'll bring my boyfriend, I'll be like, yeah. Just tell everybody you're single, and I won't even, you know, you do you, I'll do me, we'll have fun.
Yeah.
Watch how the reactions of other, with each other's
face,
that's fun.
I think it'd be funny, yeah.
You see, our very first event is just family and friends, so we know everybody, right? But we're gonna have to change voices so that they wouldn't be able to know who is on the panel. So Christina, the most hottest girl in Vegas right now, actually sat down on the blindfold. And then I just pick everybody, whoever is here, because it's the first night is friends and family.
Yeah.
So you know, everybody's married, everybody is with somebody. So we I just pull their guys in there, and then we change their voice. And it's just the most amazing one. She have no clue who are these guys. She is asking the question.
Wow.
It is so fun.
It sounds
so
funny.
I might do that. Since yeah. Might be like, so is that my
boyfriend? And we're not telling you who are we blindfolding, right?
So you would, that sounds like
so
fun.
So you're gonna be like, maybe that, maybe, you don't know. Mm-hmm. Because we're gonna blindfold you first before we go and pick up the guys.
And then, so that's on Saturday night,
on Saturday
right?
night, yes.
Okay, so I'll just come down here on one Saturday's after work. I'm gonna be a little late.
Very, very.
And then I'll invite Mimi. Yes. She's not working the next day, she's gonna come out.
Yeah, it's 9 p.m. Sometimes we feel it's like 8:50 because the last event, We have bachelor and bachelorette blindfolded at different times.
Yeah.
So one is the first is the bachelor, then we have three girls panel, and then after that, while the speed dating is still moving, the speed dating is just keep never stop.
Oh wow, how funny!
But the
how many people show up?
Oh, we have like maybe 30 people on the first night.
I'll start telling people at my job, all my clients.
Yes, please. I have
blood and steam.
Oh, you gotta have to come to the studio because I have all those flyers.
Okay.
I'm gonna text you. You can do that.
Because then I can start handing those out too.
Yes.
I would love that. Yeah.
Yeah, they would love that. Nobody is doing this. Only us.
Yeah.
And it's right here at Chanclas Cantina. It's so much fun. But by the way,
who doesn't like Chanclas?
Yeah, exactly. You know what's funny? I know, right?
Chocolate. I would totally show mine, but then I'd be doing a panel.
Yours are the most sandally. You have to show them.
Okay.
That's beautiful.
Sandals, chocolate, sandals.
That is not leaving.
But anyway, this is the best part. This is the best part. Do you want to hear the best part?
Yes.
I am sitting down on the speed dating, so I'm on the market.
Woo! So are you going to sit in on it, on the speed dating?
Wow.
Because I have to come and just do it with you just for the fun of it. I don't want to date and I don't want to meet somebody.
But that's what I'm saying. It's like not to really
but just to go for the
it's
entertainment.
Actually, yeah.
For the entertainment.
Yeah. See, I don't want to date.
Yeah, I don't want to date. I don't want a man in my life.
That's it. Yeah. No, not
Jesus
like,
is my man. He's my blood of Jesus ring.
You know, that's the fun of it. Is you know, you are having fun in there.
Yes, entertained and go home.
It is
it's
more
important, you know, the human connection and to be able to talk to people.
I love
so
to have
important.
Fun. So yeah.
Yeah. So it's gonna be so much fun. We gonna be doing this every Saturday night, 6 to 9 p.m. So if you want to join us, you know, the thing is the experience. It's not about, you know, about finding the person you want to date or you want to be with. It is more about the experience. Because you imagine back in the days, everybody loved the blindfold dating and the dating game
and
show.
And I've done that, like in college. When I was in college, I went to one, it was like for Valentine's Day. I was a freshman and I was like, okay. I would sign up for all the little events because I was new.
To the school.
And we did something like that.
Yeah.
And it was funny is I actually kind of developed a crush on one of the guys. And then like a week later, he was dating one of my roommates. So I was like, okay, this is awkward.
Yeah, I know, right? Yeah.
We live in the dorms, so.
Okay, yeah. I think this is not right. But this is so.
Yeah, it's awkward to meet each other.
Yep. So it's so much fun. So yeah, please go ahead and register now. One Night Stand, VegasStyle.com. That way, you know, I always suggest you guys go and sign up now. You pay your $10 and then get your information. That way I can actually, or we can, actually you're going to be working on that actually every Wednesday. But so that we already know who are we picking instead of seeing you guys here and picking you, because we wanted to know who's the bachelor ahead of time kind of thing. But right now is we're just picking who is coming. Hey, that's going to be our bachelorette or bachelor kind of thing. But I think I want you to be the bachelorette. That's going to be a lot of fun.
Okay, I'll be a bachelorette for an evening. Yeah. Whatever you want, Maria.
She's going to be the bachelorette. So anyways, yeah, well, we're out of here. Thank you so much for tuning in tonight. Next week, we're going to have brand new guests on Let's Talk World. And I hope that we can do our Two Hot Chicks.
Yes.
Next week, every 6 p.m. Two Hot Chicks is a comedy talk show.
Comedy talk show.
Yeah, we are just talking about... Yeah. Well, figure it out.
I love laughing.
Yeah, Two Hot Chicks. So thank you so much. Please don't forget to... Oh, this show is going to be streaming live tomorrow at 3 p.m. on socialmediashows.com. And I'll try to restream it at the same panel like YouTube, Twitter, Twitch, Facebook too. Because I know that the internet is not cooperating at this time. But thank you so much for viewing us. And please don't forget to subscribe, follow us on Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, and thank you so much for supporting all our shows. And a great night.
It's nice seeing you guys again.
Thank you for watching Let's Talk World. I hope you enjoyed our featured guests for the day. Please visit us on socialmediashows.com, subscribe on our channel on YouTube, and follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and Periscope. Don't forget to share and like and comment on our show. Thank you so much, and I'll see you guys again next week.